The federal government has accused gas companies of threatening the nation after Shell put a hold on sales to the Australian east coast. It is just one of a number of battles the Albanese government is fighting as it tries to pass its energy bill and bring price relief to businesses and families. Our network political editor Peter Van Onselen has more.
The government has responded to industry claims new price caps on coal and gas present a risk to their businesses.
Gas companies want to protect their profits. We want to protect the Australian people.
Shell is basically saying, holding the rest of the country to ransom.
I don't think they're going to get a lot of sympathy.
These giants need to pay their fair share of tax.
If companies decide not to invest in Australia, then you're going to have a situation where we lose jobs.
The opposition unimpressed by Labor's interventionist response to the energy crisis.
You didn't see these sorts of disruptions, market interventions, when we were in government.
We've had less supply because they didn't have that investment certainty under the former government.
Irrespective of who is to blame, all sides agree consumers need relief.
Because of the shock out of the budget, the government now has cobbled together a policy.
One that needs the support of the Greens when Parliament reconvenes on Thursday.
We're looking at this in good faith. I know the opposition's just saying no, they're not interested.
The opposition questioning the need to recall Parliament this year.
Mr Albanese and the Labor government have not explained why it needs to be dealt with this Thursday.
227 parliamentarians are due to fly to Canberra from right around the country, as well as many of their staff.
This is going to cost more than $1 million.
This is an urgent sitting of Parliament because we're facing an urgent situation.
The bill relief will only be finalised by National Cabinet in March next year.
Which is why the rush to legislate is more about fulfilling Labor's promise to act before Christmas. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.